weather from the penguin on the beach? Well, penguins can be much more fascinating than they seem. Let me explain why. Let's say you were on an expedition to study cute penguins. Which one of these locations you definitely wouldn't find them? If you chose the Arctic, you're right. Penguins evolved to live in the south. As they're flightless, it wouldn't be easy to go to the north. Especially today, when there's simply too much warm, nutrient-poor water between them and the Arctic. It would be for us to walk around in winter clothes in the way to summer. So unfortunately, we'll probably never see a polar bear fighting a penguin, even though it'd be really epic. What about the other options though? Isn't Ecuador just too hot for them? Yes, it really is, but not for every penguin. There are about 18 kinds of them. And 5 can live in warmer temperatures, including the Galapagos penguin that can support incredible 27 degrees Celsius. The reason they can survive to such hot temperatures is due to the Humboldt and Krumboldt currents, which are basically cold subsurface water streams that flow eastward close to the equator. The current helps the penguins stay cool, but even more importantly, it helps them eat. They also have adaptations to survive the strong sun. In fact, these penguins are so good at keeping warm that they have a problem with overheating during summer months. Some of the species even spend part of the year in the desert. Yes, in the desert, such as in Punta Tombo in Argentina. But why can most of them live in higher temperatures? Well, because of their short and rigid feathers forming an air trap, which acts as a perfect insulator when the bird's submerged. But this also makes it really hard, even for more climate penguins, to maintain a comfortable temperature in hot locations. And they can even get heatstroke, just like us. While penguins are well adapted to their environments, human impacts are hitting their homes too hard and too fast for them to cope. The threats are numerous, including habitat loss, pollution, disease, reduced food availability, and more. I know it's hard to talk about climate change, but for penguins and other animals that live in the poles, if there's too much sea ice, trips to bring food from the ocean become longer and arduous, and their chicks may starve. And with too little sea ice, the chicks are at risk of drowning. And worse, a study by Global Change Biology estimates that in this scenario, 98% of the imperial penguin colonies will be extinct by 2100. If you find this video at least a bit interesting, consider checking the links below to learn more about it. And you can help the penguins and your favorite animal by donating to Wildlife Arc to help. Like, why not?